In last 6 months, more than 1,000 books have been written about it. Scientists all over the world are studying it. Institutes or universities all across the world are teaching about it. Google Analytics show that people are searching for it. In fact, it has been humanity's oldest pursuits. Any guesses what I'm talking about? The one thing which everybody is searching for is called happiness. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters.
Good evening.
And a very warm welcome to the guests. It was a usual Monday morning. I was driving towards my office. As I was waiting at one of the signals, I heard a knock on my window. Knock, knock. I rolled down the windows to see an old man standing there, you know, with a tattered clothes, wrinkled skin, deep eyes, asking for some money. I started searching for some change on the dashboard. I couldn't find any. So I reached to my wallet and opened it. And as I opened my wallet, oops, there was only 100 rupee note in my wallet. Now he had been watching me doing all this, and I didn't want to disappoint him. So I gave that 100 rupees to him. It was very nice. I felt nice to see the broad smile on his face, twinkle in his eyes. I think I had made his day. As I was waiting at the signal, he stood at the distance from my car and continuously watching me. I just thought to myself, what must he be thinking about? And a thought came to my mind. You know, you must be thinking, oh boy, you must be the happiest person on the earth. You've got a car, you've got a house, you've got a loving family back there. You work for a corporation. Work for a corporation, earn handsome money. You have a bank balance, roam around the country, stay in 5-star hotels and give 100 rupees to a beggar. You must be this fantastically happy person on the planet Earth. But as I reflected, I got a little shocked. Because in spite of having all those things, I was not the person he was talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, most of us sitting here, rather all of us sitting here, will have a lot of luxuries in our lives. But still, we are not the happiest lot. In fact, research shows that if you are able to manage 3 meals in a day, if you have a roof on your head, you are better than at least 70% of the world's population. In the recent survey done by United Nations, India was ranked 111th. On Global Happiness Index. Not only that, we were ranked much after than countries like Bangladesh and Pakistan. You know, there are many reasons why we're not happy. I'm going to talk to you about two reasons, two main reasons. Reason number one, we started looking for happiness in the wrong places. We thought having a big car will make us happy. Having a big house will make us happy. Going to foreign vacations will make us happy. In fact, we carved out a formula which said, happiness is directly proportional to the amount of money I have in my bank. The psychologist at Howard University did one research on the people who had won lotteries. Imagine people winning millions of dollars or crores of rupees. And the results were surprising. They said after some time of winning the lotteries, after 3 months, after 6 months, 10 months, 12 months, depending on the person, the happiness levels of the people came to the original one where they started. Which means, it is not something external, ladies and gentlemen, it is something which is internal. It's about the decision which you make to be happy or not to be happy. Mr. Abraham Lincoln once said, people are usually as happy as they make their minds to be. So that was reason number one. Reason two, we learned this beautiful art called postponement. You know, when God sent us down, he said, boy, I'm sending you on the beautiful place, the beautiful creation of mine. Go, be merry, be happy. But we landed here, after a few years, you know, we learned comparing. We learned this beautiful art or beautiful place called the other side, where the grass always seemed greener for us. As a school child, we said, God, I promise I'll be happy, just let me go to college. And just look at them, no uniform, no homework. He goes on a bike, he's got a girlfriend, I just look at them, he holds that cigarette. Oof, wow. And guess what? We went to college just to realize the harsh realities of the life. And to make one more promise, God, one job please, one job. I promise this time pakka I'll be happy. And guess what? We got a job. I don't want to tell the whole story after getting a job. From assistant manager to senior manager. From a bike to a small car to a big car. From a rented apartment to 2 BHK to 3 BHK. From 5 lakh to 10 lakh to 20 lakh to 30 lakh, we made all transitions accept happiness. We forgot to savor the moment. We forgot to enjoy the present. We forgot to enjoy whatever we have right now with us. An African proverb says, if you are too busy to enjoy or to have, you are too busy. Ladies and gentlemen, I have two small requests. My invitation is to make two small changes in your life. One, make a decision. Take the strong decision, irrespective of what my life has to offer to me, I will be happy. One. Number two, slow down, guys. Slow down. Savor the moment. Enjoy the present. Be thankful for whatever you have. Mr. Albert Einstein once said, a table, a chair, a soup of a bowl, and why you eat. What else do I require to be happy? Thank you.